Hola, hola. Vamos a empezar a tener clase en línea, como ustedes saben, y sé que esto no es ideal, pero vamos a intentar. We're going to try to do these online videos, and I'm going to try to speak in Spanish a bunch, but of course, this isn't the most ideal way of teaching, but I'm going to do my best here. Vamos a empezar con el verbo del día. El verbo del día de hoy es asistir a. Asistir means to attend. It looks like to assist, but it does not mean assist. This is called a false cognate. Asistir a. You always have to say that preposition a. It means to attend. For example, I go to Elkhart Christian Academy. Asisto a ECA. Bueno, tenemos pretérito. I, iste, io, imos, iero. I attended. Imperfecto. Ia, ias, ia, íamos, ían. I was attending. Asisto es, e, imos en, I attend. Ojalá que asista as a amos an. I hope I attend. Then there's the future tense. Asistiré, the entire verb plus e, as a amos an. I will attend. That is our verb of the day. It's one of our vocab from Unit 5, Lección 2. Okay, speaking of Unit 5, Lección 2, let's go to our textbook on page 319. Vamos ahí. Y vamos a leer la lista. El primer día quiero leer la lista. On this first day, I want to read the list to you. The first day that we're reviewing over the vocab that you studied yesterday. And so I want to pronounce the words for you. And the first one is to attend a show. Asistir a un espectáculo. A show is an espectáculo. Dormir una siesta. Take a nap. And I'm not sure if you guys are doing a lot of that recently, but it is how you say that. This chapter, we're talking about leisure. Encontrarse con, to meet up with. Pasar un buen rato, to have a good time. Relajarse, to relax. Then there's chess, ajedrez. Yeah, ajedrez, chess. Billar, not Mr. Biller, but rather pool. Dados, sounds like fingers. You use your fingers to throw the dados with your dedos. Dados, dice. Damas, damas means checkers. It also means ladies, as in ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros. Damas means checkers. Then we have a premiere or a debut of a movie, estreno. I remember one year I had some girls pronouncing that debut. It is pronounced debut or premiere. The first time you show a movie, it's a estreno. And then game pieces like checker pieces or chess pieces. A piece is a ficha. Grupo musical. Juego de mesa, it's a table game or a board game. Manta is a blanket that covers up something. Música bailable. Orquesta, notice it has no R in it. Naipes. Pasatiempo. Ocio is your leisure. Pasatiempo like pastimes, hobbies, that kind of thing. Okay, other words and actions. We have cozy, acogedor. We have acting, actuación. We have the environment or atmosphere, ambiente. You might remember that from when we studied el medio ambiente. We have discutir, to discuss or to argue something. We're just discussing this. It could be either to discuss or to argue. Formal, duh. Informal, once again. Then you have the street musician. It's a músico callejero. We have a resolution, resolución. We have to solve something, resolver. We have a noise, ruido. That was a rude noise. Ruido, noise. We have a street vendor, is a vendedor ambulante. It's a traveling salesperson. Right, and then reporting what someone said. To go to a meeting is asistir a una reunión. Reunión is a meeting or a reunion. Charlar, charlar is to chat. We had salón de charlas, the verb is charlar. Comentar, literally comment with an AR, comentar. Concluir, to conclude. Debatir, to debate. El encuentro is an encounter. Yeah, it's from the verb encontrar. The yo form is the noun. An encounter. I just had an encounter. I just met up with somebody. We have intercambiar opiniones. You give your opinion, I give mine. And then there's relatar, to relate, to tell something. What happened? Relátame, dime, cuéntame, to relate what happened. So that's your vocab. You need to be reading your list once each day, of course. And we'll do it this different ways. We won't always videotape myself reading them. But that's one of the things. The other thing I'd like you to do, ahora quiero que ustedes vayan en el texto a página 301, 301 en el texto, Y vamos a leer el blog. Vamos a leer el blog. I'm going to play it on the computer and you can listen to the professionals. I want you to read. Pongan sus ojos en las palabras mientras lee. Please put your eyes on the words as she reads. It's going to take 2 minutes and 43 seconds.
Gladys Belgrano es una joven peruana que está participando en una conferencia de la Organización de las Naciones Unidas en Lima. Cada noche, Gladys escribe en su blog para describir qué pasó durante el día.
Okay, so far we're learning that Gladys is a young Peruvian girl that's participating in a conference of the United Nations in Lima. Every night, Gladys writes in her blog to say what happened during the day. So now we're going to read Gladys's blog. What's happening at this amazing, riveting United Nations conference?
Blog de Gladys. Sobre el blog. Aquí escribo mis experiencias en la escuela y en otras actividades relacionadas con mi educación. Todas las noches escribo cosas nuevas para que todos sepan qué ocurrió en mi día de actividad.
Aquí explica lo que hace en su blog. Here she's explaining just what she does in her blog. Now, let's go to the next part.
Conferencia de la ONU en Lima. Publicado el 12 de marzo. Participo en una conferencia estudiantil de la ONU. Ya se acabó el primer día del programa. Y ahora estoy relajándome en mi habitación antes de encontrarme con un grupo de gente para salir.
Okay, I participated in a conference of the United Nations. The first day ended, and now I'm just relaxing in my bedroom before hanging out with a group of people.
¡Qué día más interesante! Anoche fui a una recepción de bienvenida y conocí en persona a los dos estudiantes que conocía del salón de charlas. Raúl y Sofía.
Last night, I got to meet in person the two people that I had been chatting to, Raúl and Sofía.
Son muy amables, aunque Raúl es un poco desorganizado. Pasé un buen rato charlando con los otros delegados y después a la cama.
Okay, apparently Raúl is a little bit disorganized, but he's really nice. I spent some time talking to them and other delegates, and then straight to the cama, a dormir.
Estaba cansadísima. Hoy asistí a varias reuniones con mi grupo, el de los países andinos. Participamos en unas actividades de grupo y luego intercambiamos opiniones y debatimos varios temas. Mañana participaremos en un encuentro con los delegados del Cono Sur para resolver un problema económico y presentar nuestras conclusiones. Mucho trabajo, pero súper interesante.
Okay, well, she's saying today she went to various meetings with her group from the Andean countries, and they did various things such as discuss issues and interchange opinions from the countries from the Cono Sur, which is the southern cone of South America, which includes Argentina, Uruguay, Paraguay, and Chile. And then they came to some conclusions. It was a lot of it work, but very interesting.
Cuatro comentarios. Un poco de descanso. Publicado el 12 de marzo. Dormiré una siesta antes de reunirme con el grupo. Vamos a un salón de baile para estudiantes. También vamos a planear una excursión a Cusco o a Trujillo. Aquí pueden ver unas fotos con mis compañeros de la conferencia. Mañana publicaré detalles sobre nuestra salida y más información sobre la conferencia. Un comentario.
Okay, so we have, I will sleep a nap, or I'll take a nap, before getting together with the group. We're going to go out to a dance place with the students, and we're also going to go plan a trip to Cusco and Trujillo, some places in Peru that are pretty cool to visit. Here's some pictures from my friends, and tomorrow I'll put these on and do some more information with the conference. Okay, so, da vuelta la página, turn the page, da vuelta la página. And we're going to contestar actividad 4. Actividad 4, buena, lee, escucha. And here we go. Actividad 4. And here we go. Actividad 4. actividad 4, página 302. Primera pregunta, completa las oraciones sobre la lectura con la información más correcta. You can pause the video and look up the first question. Mientras escribe, Gladys está, flip the page back and see what is Gladys doing while she's writing. Okay, pause, and the answer is, está relajándose en su habitación, or something like that. She's just relaxing in her room. The second question. Gladys conoció a, Gladys met, look back, Raúl y Sofía, las personas del salón de charlas. Okay. Próxima pregunta. Hoy Gladys participó en, today Gladys participated in varias reuniones con su grupo. Número 4. Mañana el grupo de Gladys va a, tomorrow Gladys's group is going to participar en un encuentro, to participate in an excursion, in an encounter, to go out on a trip to those two different cities we mentioned. Okay? Número 5. Los dos grupos van a, both groups are going to, flip back, resolver un problema económico. They're going to solve an economic problem. And finally, remember to pause your video after the question. Ahora Gladys quiere. Now Gladys wants dormir una siesta. She wants to take a nap. Sleep a siesta. Quiere dormir una siesta. Okay, so there's our little actividad. Now I'm going to teach you one other little thing today, and it's called the nota gramatical. What is the difference between the word que and qual? And usually in Spanish 3 at this time of year, everybody knows the difference except for those who didn't learn the Spanish 1 portion of this. So I'm going to explain it. It's real simple. Que means what? Qual means what? However, there is a slight difference. Que is what and asks for a definition. So if I say volcán, and somebody's like, wait, what's a volcán? ¿Qué es un volcán? It's asking for what it is. Or you have something in your hand there. ¿Qué es? What is it? I'm looking to identify it or asking for a definition. ¿Qué? ¿Cuál also means what, but it also means which. And it asks for a selection from a group. So you look outside, you see a bunch of cars, and you're like, ¿cuál es tu carro? Which one is your car? Or you might have a lot of phone numbers out there and say, ¿cuál es tu número? What's your number? There's a selection, there's a big group. Or ¿cuál es la fecha? You could also say, ¿qué es la fecha? More common to say, ¿cuál? That's why these words are a little bit interchangeable, but ¿cuál? You're really safe to use which. Okay? So we're going to see some answers. You're going to tell me what the question was. Once again, pausing the video, activity 5. Just hang in there. This is the last activity that we're doing on this video. Okay? And what do we have for minutes? We're at muchos minutos so far. 13. All right. So, actividad 5. Haz la pregunta. You guys have to make the question. Haz la pregunta. Lee las siguientes respuestas. Read the following answers. Y dile cuál o qué. Qué o cuál. So, we have the model says, el ajedrez es un juego de mesa. Chess is a board game. So the question would have been, what is chess? Which is, ¿qué es ajedrez? We're looking for a definition. What is chess? Oh, chess is a board game. ¿Qué es? Not cuál es. Cuál would be, which is chess? Like if there's a checkerboard and a chess board, well, the same thing. A checkerboard set up and a chess board, you say, which one? ¿Cuál es? But if I just like, what is chess? ¿Qué es? Oh, it's un juego de mesa. It's just a table game. All right, so activity 5, number 1. Here's the answers, very good, right? It says, las fichas del ajedrez son el rey, la reina, la torre, el caballo, el peón y el alfil. The pieces in chess are the king, the queen, the tower, what do we call that? The rook, the horse, the knight, I guess we call it, el peón, the pawn, and the alfil, which we call in English the bishop. What's the question here? Is it qué or cuál? Pause the video, okay? Answer. ¿Cuáles son las fichas de ajedrez? Which are the chess pieces? There's a lot of different kinds. ¿Cuáles son? You could possibly say queson, but cual is a much better because there's a selection of different kinds of pieces. Número dos. Un estreno es la primera vez que se presenta una película o una obra. A premiere, a debut, is the first time a movie is presented, or a drama. Pause the video. ¿Qué es un estreno? What is a premiere? Oh, it's the first time. Okay, once again, we're giving the answer. You come up with what was the question. It's kind of like Jeopardy. Número tres. La música que más me gusta es la música bailable. Okay, pause the video. I like either for this one, really. ¿Qué es la música que te gusta? What is the music that you like? Or even better choice is ¿cuál es? Why ¿cuál? Because there's a selection. There's rap, there's reggae, there's pop, there's jazz, there's who knows the kind of music that you listen to. But anyway, ¿cuál es la música que te gusta más? ¿Qué es la música would also do? The answer key has it as K, but qual also works perfectly for that one. That's why I say they're interchangeable. Number four, de estos dos restaurantes, prefiero el restaurante formal. From these two restaurants, I prefer the formal one. Think of the question. ¿Cuál de estos restaurantes prefieres? Which of the two restaurants do you prefer? There's a selection, there's two. Which one do you prefer? What one do you prefer? ¿Cuál? All right, next one, number five. Una charla es una conversación informal. A chat is an informal conversation. Well, think about it. ¿Qué es una charla? What? I'm looking for the definition. What is a chat? Es una conversación informal. Six, la orquesta del director Jaime Serra se llama Orquesta Serra. The orchestra of Jaime Serra is called Orquesta Serra. Pause. ¿Cuál es la orquesta del director Jaime Serra? Which one is Jaime's? KS would also do better to say cuál because there's lots of orchestras. That's Jaime Serra's. Okay, and número siete, necesito dormir una siesta para relajarme.